Everyone, in this video we've got a Golf Mark 8 in, which has an issue with the keyless entry and central locking. This is because someone's replaced the door on this car, but they haven't replaced the wiring loom and the door lock. So follow us through where we're going to remove the door handle, remove the door card, the window assembly, the glass, in order to change the wiring. We'll start off by removing the clips over here, taking the screws out for the door card, one here and one here. Unclip the door panel, lifting it up, and then attacking the insides. Remove a little cover over here, behind the handle, with a pick tool. And then there's a little cover here, and there's two T30 bolts in order to that hold the door panel on. So we've unclipped this all the way around. Now remember, there's a clip here, so we've got to do is slide it up, and then the door panel comes off. One thing to note is, when you take the door panel off, you pull it off all the way around the bottom, around the top. But over here, you've got this clip here. Now, this clip breaks regularly. Now, the thing to remember is to slide this up and then take it out to stop everything breaking. This is your standard modern clip from Volkswagen. You give it a pull. I've just turned that around. You pull it out and unclip it. Removing the door glass on these is a bit different to the older generation of Volkswagens. We took the motor off and just dropped the glass down, so we have access to this hole here and this hole here. Now, if you look at the back there, you can see a hole in the glass and a little clip. Now, I'm going to push this here and push the clip at the back. When I take the regulator out, you'll see, but once you push this clip back with a screwdriver, you can then slide the glass up out of the clip assembly. And the same on this back clip here, you push it backwards and you slide the glass up, and you can unclip the glass and take it out. And then we can proceed to removing the regulator. So we've slid the glass out and we've unplugged all the electrical connectors from the side crash sensor, the window motor, the handle, and also the door lock. So we've got all of these out. We've removed these two covers here and removed the two T30 bolts here. And now you've got to unlock the winder. And these, it's a 13mm bolt. I just turn these till they stop. And what that does is removes what they call the support panel, which is obviously the window regulator assembly. Okay, now just push this cable in so it stops coming in the way. So when you're doing it single-handedly, it's slid out nicely. Here's your window regulator assembly that just slides out. Got access to the door, so you can clean out whatever's in the bottom. Now, just having a look at this window regulator. So obviously we were looking at how the glass comes out, and you can see here you've got a prong here and you've got a prong here. So this is what you're pushing. So when you're going through the window there at the back, you're effectively pushing this out like this, so the glass comes out. Just there, you can see there. Okay, get the door handle out. You put a tool in this hole here using a blunt Torx screwdriver, and you're looking for this hole over here. And when you push that in, it pulls a lever and releases the handle. Now I'm gonna try do this with one hand. So let's get that in. And you push it in, and just give that a bit of a push on the leg. And while I'm holding that, the handle just comes out. You can then slide the handle out. This, make sure, watch that rubber seal there. And then you can unclip the clip for the keyless entry and the illumination. Once you've got the bolt out, which is over here, you just take the lock cylinder, give it a wiggle, and it just slides out like this. Moving the door handle carrier is very easy. Remove the one screw at the rear here, then it slides inwards, and you just slide it forward, it drops out. We'll then proceed to remove these two bolts here so we can get the door lock out. Here's the door lock side by side. The one that we need is the one at the donor unit, which is 016C. Now this may very well just be a revision, or it might be something different. But the main thing is the Kessie wiring loom here has four wires, whereas the one that came out only had two wires. So I'm assuming that's for door handle illumination, but this one was for illumination and the Kessie system. So we'll put this door lock back in this door and then get the handle carrier in, and still got to swap the wiring loom out. We're actually going to pull the wiring out this way and through the door. And take it out here so we can feed the new one in, because we're going to use the old the old regulator, which is in better condition, and the old wiring loom, which is the correct one. Now, to get the joint off here, just slide that up like most Volkswagen Audis. Let me get a screwdriver. Standard Volkswagen fashion, just pull the tang up. Make sure you do it equally, like that. And that takes this off. See your plug there. Now, the tangs on the back of this are a bit more complex, which I'll need to use two hands, but I'll show you on the replacement loom. So that's how it sits in the door. So you've got to get behind with a pick tool and just basically press these three clips down. And then it, well, it actually sits this way. So you press these three clips down, slide the top out, and then slide it through the handle, through the hole in the door. I've pressed those clips and got them out. I can now slide that into the door and push the loom all the way. And then once that's through over here, I can unclip it on the bottom, here, here, and here. And I can pull it through the hole over here. This is the window regulator assembly that came off the original door. And we've just left the wiring on there because it's easier. And this was in better condition. We're going to feed the door lock release cable and the wiring for the door handle through the hole, which is over here. And then seat the window regulator assembly in, making sure all these are in the unlocked position. So they line up in these holes here. And then we can feed the wiring back through. And we'll have to tie it back on that clip because that clip didn't come out and we didn't want to break it. So there's a bit of pressure from the door lock release cable. I can use both hands, but we'll get that in position. Line it up all the way. And then whilst we hold the window regulator, we can pull this through so that the rubber grommet sits correctly. Just like that. And you can see now we've got the correct loom here. Plugs into there, plugs into the door lock here. Okay, and we can then tighten the window regulator back into position. Before you start, make sure those T30s are lined up. And I'm just gonna go around now and just turn it until the mark reaches there. So the arrow reaches the marker. No bolts, just clips nowadays. So that's done. And now we'll put the T30s in on the top. It's a bit hard when you're recording and doing this with one hand. So we've reconnected the loom here, put the grommet in, put the green clips in. We still have to tape it back to that clip at the back there, but it'll show you here. This one just sits like this and it clips in on the top. And then the plug for the A pillar just slides over and you press the lock down. And now we can get this one tied in just over here. And the light shows just like this. Getting the connections on, this is for the wing mirror. So it's pretty hard to get these the wrong way around. That one goes in there. Let's do this in an order where it's a bit tidy. So this one slides onto the control module. Let's find out which way it slides. It slides this way. There we go. This way we've got this one on top. This one's for the motor, the window motor. You've got this one here. Okay, then there's one that connects onto here, which is this blue one. Nope. I had this one on the wrong way around. It goes this way. Slides in there. This one goes here. Okay, don't forget to lock the lock. So we now just check everything's in. We can put all the grommets back. Well, this one actually had stickers. So let's just put the stickers back. We've got the grommets for the window regulator, but we'll put the glass in first. And then all the rest of them are for the actual door panel. Getting the glass in, we tilt and put the front section in, and then we put the rear section in, and then slide the glass down and look through the window here to see the glass is sitting in the clip assembly correctly. And you push it down. And then when you push it down, you'll see that the catch has gone through the hole and it's holding the glass in the right place. Now this one needs to move slightly forward and upwards. So looking at the other regulator, you've got to get the glass back in this groove here where that goes in the hole. Final finishing touches, get this clip back in, or this cover, goes there, just clips in at the bottom, like that, nice and neat. And this one just goes over here, like this. So we use the pick to remove them over here, and a pick in the corner there, pop that off. There you have it. Keyless entry is now working. Lock. And unlock. We hope you found our video useful. And if you did, please hit like, share, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thank you very much for watching.